Have you ever wanted to have a customer or a client book a meeting, but you need multiple people from your team to be in that meeting? Well, team meeting links are the ways to do that inside of HubSpot.
Welcome to HubSpot Hacks, where we help you get more out of HubSpot.
If you've watched any of our previous videos, you'll find out how to set up your meeting link inside of HubSpot. But if you have the free or sales starter version, that link is just going to be for you. But if you have Sales Pro or Sales Enterprise, there's a feature called Team Meetings Link, and that allows you to set up a link where you can have multiple people's calendars sync to that very action, and then it looks for availability for everybody there. So it's similar to if you use something like MixMax or Calendly, but this is gonna be right inside of HubSpot, so all of that activity to that meeting gets tracked on the contact record, and then you have all those automations that you can work with as well. So let's go ahead and dive in and talk about how to set up a team meeting link. So we're going to be in this meetings area here, still under the sales tab, and click meetings. And we're still going to click on this create meeting link, and it's going to ask me personal or team. So in this case, we're going to click on team. And again, this is only for people that have the Sales Pro seat, so or Sales Enterprise, either of those two. If you have team members, you've got maybe 15 people on your portal and only two of you have the Sales Pro, this can still only be used with those two people. So we've got two types here to choose from. We've got group availability and round robin availability. So group availability is everybody on that meeting link has to have that time available in order for them to have to show on the calendar that they can book that meeting. So if Jason and I and Tyler are on a meeting link, then the client has to book a time that all three of us have available on our calendar. For round robin availability, that is, we've got, let's say, five sales reps, and we want to make sure that you have availability on at least one of them. So in the same way that round robin with like lead assigning leads works, you're going to find that we're going to rotate people based on their availability inside of that meeting link. So we're going to show you actually this group availability, but it's going to function the same way. So if you need help with either of those scenarios, there's this click view examples, which HubSpot will give you a couple of examples for the application of these different types. So I'm going to click group availability, and then it's going to automatically assume that I want to be part of this group, which is a no-brainer here, but we're going to select Tyler. So let's say I want to make sure that if we have a free consultation request on our website, you can click and schedule that with our team, that Tyler and I are both going to be on that call and we both have to be available. So I'm going to click next. Now, this meeting headline, this is what shows up to the prospect or the client or whoever's using this meeting link. This is what shows up to them at the top of the calendar. So, usually one of these things, making it pretty straightforward and no-brainer. So, book a meeting with Tyler and Allie is one option. If this happens to be the round robin availability, it might just be book a consultation or, book an intro call or book a demo. If Tyler and Allie both run, let's say, a marketing analysis meeting, we might say, book a marketing analysis, and then it just is implied that both of us are going to be in that meeting. Now, the meeting name here is the name that you want to have internal. So if we go back, we're going to go back quick and cancel this out. This is the meeting name that you're going to see inside of your HubSpot portal. So that's where that comes from. So let's do this one more time here. We're going to add Tyler and next. So we're going to call this meeting with Tyler, book a meeting with Tyler and Allie. Now this is going to be the meetings link. If you haven't set up your meetings link this way, go back to that meetings link video and watch that, because this is a custom URL that's linked to our domain or our subdomain, that is. Otherwise, it's going to show app.hubspot here, but this is a nice way to brand that. This is what's going to show up if someone clicks on that meeting link. So even if I have it in an email, this is going to show up in the browser. So I don't want it to say, I'm going to try and convert this customer. So I might just call this, Tyler Alley. You usually can't change this going forward, so make sure you're careful with this. Meeting type, if you choose to have meeting type set up on the back end of HubSpot, this is going to be how you classify that meeting. So in this case, we have what we call a discovery meeting set up. And then we have different durations that the person can choose from. So here I'm going to choose either an hour or 30 minutes. Okay, so now we're going to configure this. If you happen to have a Zoom link, I know I use Zoom or Uber Conference to automatically create that location each time. If it's an in-person meeting, you might list your address to your office. This is, again, this is going to be provided to the person once they book. And the invite subject, so when someone uses this team meeting link, it's going to send them an automatic email, and that email subject is going to display right here. So I might choose to use their contact token. I might say meeting with Tyler and Allie, or let's actually say Simple Strat, since that's the company name here. And then, and we're going to use an insert token, first name from company name. So that would be the invite subject that comes in their email. And then I can enter a description here. I'm going to choose my language, date, and format. Email notifications would be send confirmation email to prospects and customers when they book. So again, this is the subject line that they would get. I'm going to pretend this is a Zoom link here. And then this would be to send a reminder on the day of the meeting. I'm not going to turn this on right now. And then availability. So in the same way that you set up your meetings link for yourself, your personal meetings link, you can set up when you want availability for this. So let's say we only want availability from 9 to noon on Mondays, and every other day we can do 9 to 5. And then these minimum notice times, buffer times, again, go watch that meetings link video setup that we've got on our YouTube channel here. And then how soon in advance meetings could be scheduled. So this is all pretty much the same as setting up your own meetings link. The caveat here is, again, this is gonna look at both of our calendars, Monday through Friday, 9 to 12 on Mondays, 9 to 5 Tuesday through Friday. And then on the next one, in the same way we set up our personal meetings link, you can ask specific questions here. So if it happens to be that every time this meeting link is used, it's gonna be for a consultation, we want to probably ask some qualifying questions on this form that Tyler and I would need to have at that meeting. So that's where to insert that. And then you're gonna have your contact properties here to choose from. So again, if you need to add properties that you need to use inside of forms, then go back and watch our video about setting up your contact record to make sure that you get that taken care of. So if we have auto submit, this is, you know, using cookies to ensure that if they've been to your website before, it's going to autofill. Kind of a nice feature if all of that doesn't have to be filled out again. And then depending on your compliance with GDPR, that's an option here. So I'm going to click on save changes. And this is my meeting link. So here's what this looks like. If I don't want to embed this on my website, there's my embed code. I'm just going to use this as a URL, and then let's take a look. All right, so this is what it looks like. It looks like Tyler and I only have availability on these 3 days next week, and it's only gonna show the options available. So let's say on the 30th, we've got 9:30. Again, all those things that you just set up show up here, and then both he and I will get a confirmation on our calendar when this person books a meeting, and then you'll get that email if you're the person filling out the form of confirmation as well. So go ahead and give it a shot. Fill out those team meetings. Especially think about the Red Robin opportunity. If you have leads coming in through your website, you want to give someone the quickest opportunity to talk to someone on your team if they're interested in buying or learning more about your product or service. For more tips, tricks, and how-tos, hit that subscribe button or drop a comment below about this video, and we'll help you out. We'll see you next time.